गुड इवनिंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज योर टीचर अब्दुल रहमान। होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर एंजॉयिंग दिस लॉकडाउन। इफ यू आर नॉट, देन प्लीज स्टडी एंड एंजॉय। एज यू नो, आवर कंट्री एंड होल द वर्ल्ड इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम द एपिडेमिक COVID-19। सो ऑल द इंस्टीट्यूट एंड यूनिवर्सिटीज started online classes or through YouTube channel. Matter of this, I also start the class of thermal engineering by YouTube channel and the Google class. So as you all know that we have studied in the classroom first law of thermodynamics and their application to the closed system or non-flow process. Now we will study the first law of thermodynamics applied to flow process or open system. Let us revise something. As you all know that the first law is defined as the law in which total energy is converted. That is, the heat supplied to the system is equal to the work done plus change in internal energy. And the mathematical statement of the first law is Q12 is equal to DE plus W12, or Q12 is equal to E2 minus E1 plus W12, where E1 is the total stored energy at initial state and E2 is the total energy at final state. And all of you know that why I have not written Q2 minus Q1 and W2 minus W1, because those are inexact differential and not a property of the system. So this is the mathematical statement for the first law of thermodynamics. Now, the first law of thermodynamics for a non-flow process. Non-flow process means closed system, non-flow. That means there is no flow. In the closed system, we know that the mass can only enter and leave the system. Energy can only leave the system and enter the system. Mass cannot enter or leave to the system. That is a closed system or non-flow process. So when we will write in first law for closed system or non-flow process, then it becomes Q12 is equal to DU plus W12, that is equal to U2 minus U1 plus W12. And all of you know that here E1 and E2 means the sum of kinetic energy, potential energy and intermolecular energy. But here, when the system is closed, the energy is only the intermolecular energy stored in the system. And when there is a velocity, when the system is kept at some height, then the potential and kinetic energy have also the system. But because it is a closed system, it has only intermolecular energy as stored energy. So this is the first law of thermodynamics for non-flow process. Now we will study application of first law to study flow process. Flow process means the process for the open system. That means the mass can interact with the system and the surrounding. Not only energy, but mass can also interact with the system and surrounding. There are lots of application of flow process in engineering. We can see that the turbine, boiler, condenser, nozzle, and compressor, etc. There are lots of application in the engineering where the mass and energy also enters the system and leaves the systems. So we will derive an equation for the steady flow process with the help of first law of thermodynamics. Steady means the system, the mass flow rate does not change with the time. You have studied in fluid mechanics. So consider there is a system, this is a system that is the inlet and it is the outlet. And the dotted line shows the boundary of the system. System boundary. Dotted line shows the system boundary. At inlet, area of cross section is A1. And outlet, area of cross section is A2. Here, the height from the datum level of the inlet is Z1. That is the height. And here, at outlet, the height, outlet is at height of Z2 from the datum level. This is the height. Now, at the inlet, let us suppose P1 is the pressure of working substance entering the system in Newton per mm square. VS1 is a specific volume working substance entering the system in meter cube per kg. That is the specific volume. And V1 is the velocity of working substance entering the at inlet in meter per second. U1 is a specific internal energy of the system in joule per kg. Specific internal energy means it is joule per kg. We have taken unit mass. Z1 is the height, as I told you, height of the inlet. Similarly, P2, VS2, V2, U2 and Z2 are the corresponding values at outlet. Outlet means P2, pressure at the outlet, VS2, specific volume at the V2, velocity, U2, internal energy per kg and Z2, height of the datum at the outlet. And so these are the properties of the system at inlet and outlet. Now there are two more terms, Q12, that is the heat supplied to the system in joule per kg. We are giving the system heat Q12 and system does work W12. System doing a work by when we have give the heat to the system, it will obviously do some work, then it will do a work W12. That is the outlet of the system, and you can see I have written it. Now, as all of you know that from the first law of thermodynamics, that the total energy entering the system per kg of the working substance is equal to the total energy leaving the substance. So, total energy entering the system is E1. System per kg is E1, and E1 is equal to internal energy plus flow work plus kinetic energy plus potential energy plus heat supplied. And here a flow work is involved. Why there is a flow work? Because there is a flow of the matter into the system. And as I have told you in the class, that whenever there is a system working, there is an open system, then there is also a pressure difference. Flow occurs due to the pressure difference. Then in the flow work, pressure energy is applied. Similarly, total energy per kg leaving the system. Before that I have written internal energy is U1 plus flow work is P1 and a specific volume BS1, pressure into volume, and kinetic energy is B1 square by 2 plus potential energy per kg is GZ1 and heat supplied is Q12. This is the equation number 1. Similarly, total energy per kg leaving the system, E2 is equal to U2 plus P2VS2 specific volume plus V2 square by 2 kinetic energy per kg plus GZ2 potential energy per kg plus work done from the system during the process. And from first law of thermodynamics, we know that energy is conserved. That means total energy entering per kg at the inlet, total energy leaving at the outlet per kg is equal, must be equal from first law of the thermodynamics. So I have written this. So E1 is equal to E2. That means U1 plus P1V S1 plus V1 square by 2 plus GZ1 plus Q12 is equal to U2 plus PV S2 plus V2 square by 2 plus GZ2 plus W12. And all we know that enthalpy, that is the, what is enthalpy? That is sum of internal energy plus product of pressure and volume. Here, because it is, we are writing per kg, so it is enthalpy joule per kg, that is P into a specific volume, and internal energy I have taken pressure in per kg. So it becomes H1 and this becomes H2. So rearranging this equation, H1 plus B1 by square by 2 plus GZ1 plus Q12 is equal to H2 plus B2 square by 2 plus GZ2 plus W12. And by rearranging, we get Q12 minus W12 is equal to H2 minus H1 plus B2 square by 2 minus B1 square by 2 plus GZ2 minus GZ1. And this equation is known as steady flow energy equation. This equation is known as a steady flow energy equation and also called application of first law of thermodynamics to flow process. So this equation can be applied to any of the device like turbine, boiler, condenser, compressor, nozzle. We can directly apply this equation to find out the work or heat supplied or change in enthalpy, that is change in enthalpy. So this equation is in joule per kg, unit is joule per kg. When we multiply it by the mass, it become total energy. So you can do it by multiplying and find out total energy per of the system, leaving or entering the system. So I have taught you very easily and very effectively. Hope you all understand this, and in the next lecture I will do a numerical on this, and after that we will do some practical application of this equation. Hope you all have enjoyed it, my lecture. Please subscribe my channel on YouTube, like it and also comment it. You can ask any doubt by commenting or by messaging me. Thank you very much. One more thing, please stay home and remain safe, because our country is suffering from a great challenge. So please stay at home and remain safe. Thank you very much.